Hare Krishna. This is English class. And all the people speak English here. Jara Bangla tell the Bengalis to go for the Any Bangla kid koi jan jane. Bangla class hocche Brahmachari kitchene. Tada building e pase. Bangla class hocche. আমি ওখানে যাব এখানে পেয়েছি হবে বেঙ্গালি ক্লাস ইজ ইন মাই ব্রহ্মচারী কিচেন রাশিয়ান ক্লাস ইন দ্য মেইন টেন্ট মেইন স্ট্যান্ড আপ Bhakti Vikas Swami comes after me. Bhakti Vindana is সেখানে যাবেন ওখানে বাংলা পাঠাবে ওখানে এয়ারপোর্টে যাব একই পাঠ করবো বাংলা Thank you.
Yeah. This text is from Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32. Shilajit Goswami has explained this verse in his commentary on the Bhagavatam. known as the Krama Sandarbha, wherein he says that Lord Krishna also appears with a golden complexion. That golden Lord Krishna is Lord Chaitanya, who is worshipped by intelligent men in this age. That is confirmed in Srimad Bhagavatam by Garga Muni, who said that although the child Krishna was blackish, he also appears in three other colors, red, white, and yellow. He exhibited his white and red complexions in the Satyam Treta ages respectfully. He did not exhibit the remaining color yellow, gold, until he appeared as Lord Chaitanya, who is known as Gaura Hari. Krishna, Varna and Krishna Chaitanya are equivalent. The name Krishna appears with both Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya Krishna. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he always engages in describing Krishna and thus enjoys transcendental bliss by chanting and remembering his name and form. Lord Krishna himself appears as Lord Chaitanya to preach the highest gospel. Lord Chaitanya always chants the holy name of Krishna and describes it also. Because he is Krishna himself, whoever meets him will automatically chant the holy name of Krishna and later describe it to others. He injects one with transcendental Krishna consciousness, which merges the chanter in transcendental bliss. In all respects, therefore, he appears before everyone as Krishna, either by personality or by sound. Simply by seeing Lord Chaitanya, one at once remembers Lord Krishna. One may therefore accept him as Vishnu Tattva. In other words, Lord Chaitanya is Lord Krishna himself. Go! His body is always decorated with ornaments of sandalwood and with sandalwood paste. By his super excellent beauty, he induces all the people of the age sense. The Lord sometimes uses weapons to defeat the demoniac, but in this age the Lord subdues them with his all-attractive feature as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Srila Jiva Goswami explains that his beauty is his astra or weapon to subdue the demons. Because he is all-attractive, it is to be understood that all the demigods lived with him as his companions. His acts were uncommon and his associates wonderful. When he propagated the Sankirtan movement, he attracted many great scholars and acharyas, especially in Bengal and Orissa. Lord Chaitanya is always accompanied by his best associates, like Lord Chaitanya. like Lord Nityananda, Advaita Gadadhar and Srivas. Srila Jiva Goswami cites a verse from the Vedic literature which says that there is no necessity of performing sacrificial demonstrations or ceremonial functions. He comments that instead of engaging in such external pompous exhibits, all people, regardless of caste, color, or creed, can assemble together and chant Hare Krishna to worship Lord Chaitanya. Krishna Varanam Vishal Krishna. Krishna Varanam Vishal Krishna indicates that prominence should be given to the name of Krishna. Lord Chaitanya taught Krishna consciousness and chanted the name of Krishna. Therefore, to worship Lord Chaitanya, everyone should together chant the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna!
Krishna Krishna!
Hare Hare!
Hare
Rama!
Hare Rama!
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 Hare
Hare!
To propagate worship in churches, temples, or mosques is not possible, because people have lost interest in that. But anywhere and everywhere people can chant Hare Krishna. This worship of Lord Chaitanya. But everywhere and anywhere people can chant Hare Krishna. This worship of Lord Chaitanya, they can perform the highest activity and fulfill the religious, highest religious purpose of satisfying the Lord. Okay. Good quote for the ministry. Srila Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, a famous disciple of Lord Chaitanya, said, the principle of transcendental devotional service having been lost, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has appeared in order to deliver again the process of devotion. He is so kind that he is distributing love of Krishna. Everyone should be attracted more and more to his lotus feet, as humming bees are attracted to a lotus flower. Everybody is more and more attracted to Lord Chaitanya's lotus feet here in Mayapur Dham. Let's give a big hum, like humming bees. Hum, hum, hum. So, this pastime of Lord Chaitanya's appearance is very special. First of all, the situation in Navadvip was very unusual. We know that India is a land of Dharma, but we also find in the Bhagavad that there's different kinds of Dharma. There's Sanatana Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, the real eternal principle of religion. But there's also Adharma, irreligion, which we find now increasingly around the world. There's also Abhadharma, which is something like Dharma, Chala Dharma, fake Dharma, kind of imitation dharma. Apadharma, Chala Dharma, form is here. Upadharma is like secondary religious principles. There's others too. There's others, there's different kinds of superficial things. Like people may do hatha yoga and some are complaining it's a religion. But they're just doing it for a good health. Not everyone is doing it for a spiritual purpose. Although it was originally meant to be a basis for spiritual advancement. So like that, there's so many different types of practices which are actually not the real thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to get the real thing, but in Amadvip at that time, people were superficially very religious. But actually they were just materialistic. People were worshipping, morally worshipping devas, devi, rather than worshipping Krishna and Vishnu. They were putting... This is Sri Madhavdas, his Prabhupada disciple. Maybe he wants to sit in a chair. Someone wants to sacrifice him. And people were marrying their daughters in big festivals. That was considered like very deep religious ceremony, marriages. Of course, it's an important ceremony, but it's not the highest principle of spiritual life. What they were doing is, okay, it's one thing to marry your daughter and put on a big festival, and they would show that their daughter was the richest, nicest marriage in the town. To show off that their family is more aristocratic, more glorious, more spiritual, more religious. So religion, and people wanted to be known as a religious person, but it wasn't spiritual. It was just for name and fame. So then someone else got defeated. He did a better wedding than mine. I must defeat him, but I have no more daughters. What to do? So I'm marrying a Shiva and a Parvati. Then he put on a bigger wedding for Shiva and Parvati, Murtis. And someone said, he defeated me. I must get him back. I will do a bigger wedding, but I have no more daughters and he already achieved a Parvati. I should do something new, something never done before. I will marry a male and female dog. Kukur vivaha, dog marriage. Where in Shastra does it say you marry dogs? Another guy, he defeated me again. Now I must get it, I'll marry a female cat and a male cat. Like this is what's going on. The Vaishnava said, what is all this? What does this have to do with religion or spiritual life? It's their ego trip. People doing big pujas to get material benefit. But hardly anyone was worshipping Vishnu. No one was chanting the holy names. In fact, they banned chanting the holy name, said it would destroy the power of the holy name. Only time you were allowed to chant was when you were bathing in the Ganges. Then they said the Ganges was pure, otherwise your impure state wasn't appropriate for chanting. There's so many examples of how the material world economically was increasing, although superficially very religious, very religious, really zero. 0.11 something, 0.001, just the name there was religion. They're going to fire you for their pet cat and dog. But it wasn't the real, it wasn't really meant to please Vishnu. Yagyasar, yagya by Vishnu, yagyasar for the pleasure of Vishnu. But theirs was yagya by aham. Yagya is for me, to make me famous. So that was the problem. So Dvaitacharya, Haridas Thakur, Srivas Thakur, they were praying for Krishna to come to correct all these anomalies. Then Krishna agreed to come on the day of about 13 months before today. Mother Jagannath Mishra had a dream that Krishna was in his heart, in his mind, went to his heart, transferred over to Sachi Mata's heart, entered into her womb. They didn't actually have relations at that time. It was an immaculate conception, a spiritual transfer. When the Lord entered from Vasudeva and went to Sachi Mata, Sachi Mata found that she was expecting a baby. And her husband was noticing that she became so beautiful. She looked like a goddess of fortune. And people were just walking up to him. Here, my dear Brahmin, take some money. He didn't have to beg for alms. People just walk up and hand him money. He was never so rich before. Because the goddess of fortune had come into his house, everything was becoming very auspicious. He told this to his wife. Everything is becoming very auspicious. Dear wife, people are just coming, giving me money. What does this mean? She said, maybe there is some great soul in my womb, and making everything auspicious. I am seeing heavenly beings coming and praying to me. The devas are coming and praying to Lord Chaitanya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And every Yuga you come as that incarnation. You come and you give out mukti, liberation. But it's very rare for you to give out love of Krishna. But in this incarnation, we understand you're going to give out freely love of Godhead. How many here want love of Godhead?
Acharya were making a little shadow visible. Mother Sanchez said, what is this? Who's in my room? Ugramira Bhavishandra. Some evil spirits are coming here. Evil spirits, be gone. Oh, Narasinghaya, front! They're gone. The devas ran away. We're supposed to be invisible to human beings. Why? They could see us. This Gauranga was playing games with us. So the two, Sachi Mata, Jagannath Mishra, they were comparing their notes. They're saying something very special is happening. Now if the baby doesn't come 9 days and 9 months and so many days, immediately they want to do cesarean. But he was in the womb 13 months. No cesarean. That's why it appeared 500 years ago. They asked, and he came just at the right time. Just like Prabhupada, he went to the West at the right time. So,
Lord Chaitanya appeared. Some say why he would appear in an inauspicious time like an eclipse. So that the eclipse, you don't need the moon when he appears, because he is more brilliant than millions of moons. Millions of moons. So Lord Chaitanya, he appeared, and the news came that Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata had a boy, and he's very beautiful, he's golden color. So all the Brahmin ladies, they started to come, putting kusa grass on his forehead, sprinkling him with rice covered with turmeric powder, akshat. So it was a happy festivity. Okay, here comes Bhakti Vikas Maharaj. I'm supposed to surrender my seat as soon as they come. It's got 100 meters. So, the devas, the devis, they came from the heavenly planets to see Lord Chaitanya disguised as Brahminical ladies. Brahmin ladies. Today is an auspicious day. The Lord appeared at the Choga Peet. We're all blessed to be here. It says that if you bathe in the Ganges today, they love for Krishna. But please be careful. On this day, we've lost our 2 devotees, and maybe more over the years. I personally saved 2 from drowning in Gaur Purnima. Don't know swimming very well, don't follow the good swimmers and go out in the middle. The Ganges is 15 meters deep. We can't get to, nobody can die, we're not dark. So be very careful. Don't go in the morning and get attacked with colors. The color holy is going on outside. After 1 o'clock we stop. 12, 1. Then you go in the afternoon. See you. Take your dip. Okay, Maharaj, where is he? Ready?